Now we are going to see standard 8 English. My Reminiscence is written by Rabindranath Tagore. Children, I hope you all know about Rabindranath Tagore. He is the one who wrote our national anthem. Okay, children. So before I will start this, let me tell you a motivational quote. Children, look deep into nature and then you will understand everything better. Once again, I repeat, look deep into nature and then you will understand everything better. Children, first let me tell you about the gist of the story. Actually, from this lesson topic, you will understand what is this lesson. Actually, my reminiscences, meaning of my reminiscences is the practice of thinking or telling about past experience. In this lesson, we are going to experience past life of Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so we are going to see the past experience of Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so then see in page number 92, they have given you a warm-up questions. They have given you a beautiful picture of nature, and then they have given you a quote over there. See, beauty lies in the beholder eyes. And then they have asked you to read the quote and observe the picture. Complete this graphic organizer. Remember to use suitable adjectives. So they have asked us to use suitable adjectives. I hope children you know what is adjective. Adjective is nothing but describing the noun. So here we have a beautiful, see here we can see waterfall, trees, mountains, then rocks, is it? Then blue sky. So you are going to describe all this. Okay ma, in that small graphic boxes. So that is what your warm-up question. Okay, now let us see about the author, which is in page number 92. Rabindranath Tagore, 1861 to 1941, he is a Nobel Prize winning Bengali poet, author, philosopher, artist and educator, wrote Gitanjali in 1912. So we all know Rabindranath Tagore, he is a famous poet. Along with that, he is an author, he is a philosopher, an artist and educator, wrote Gitanjali in the year 1912. So My Reminiscences was written and published in his 50th year shortly before he started on a trip to Europe and America for his failing health in 1912. So actually he was not feeling well during 1912. So that is at the age of 15th. So before he started moving to America and Europe, he wrote this novel, you can say, My Reminiscences. From that one part is given to you. Okay. It was in the course of this trip that he wrote for the first time in English language for publication. So, for the first time he wrote in English for publication. Okay, children. So, this is about the author. Okay. Now, we shall see in depth about the lesson. Okay, ma? So, listen to the teacher and read the section. I am reading the first paragraph, which is in page number 93. When I returned home from the outset of my second voyage to England, my brother Jotinder and his sister-in-law were living in a riverside villa at Chandanagar, and there I went to stay with them. See here, when I returned home from the outset of my second voyage to England, so here he came to England, that is he came back from England to India. So from the second time he went to England and again he came back to India and he went to live along with his brother. His brother name is Jyotindra and sister-in-law and his brother wife, and they were all living at the river side of Chandanagar. So near the river side, where this river side is present, in the Chandanagar, and there I went to stay with them. Who? Rabindranath Tagore. So actually here the lesson starts with the Rabindranath Tagore. For the second time he went to England and he came back. Voyage is nothing but trip. He went to England and came back to India once again, and he lived with his brother and brother wife, that is his Sushanika, and at the Chandanagar near the riverside. Okay, see the Ganges again those ineffable days and night, languid with joy, sad with longing, attuned to the plaintive babbling of the river along the cool shade of its wooded banks. This Bengali sky full of light, this south breeze, this full of river. how beautifully he has explained the Ganga River. So once again he saw the Ganga River, that is why they are given the Ganges again. So once again he got admired, he got himself very happy by seeing the Ganga River once again. Again those ineffable days, ineffable, nothing but beyond expression, too great to express, that great days. So he started remembering that great days, that is his childhood day days. Actually this story, you know, it tells about the first 25 years of Rabindranath Tagore. How the first 25 years of Rabindranath Tagore near the Ganga River, how the place where he lived, where he watched, where he played, how the place was after 50 years, how the place has changed. So this is what he is saying in this lesson. Okay. So here he is saying that the Ganges again. Again those ineffable days, ineffable days, nothing but that is those great days and night. Languid, meaning of languid is moving slowly with joy, sad with longing, that is, so it just moved with joy, and along with that, see, happiness and sadness both is there in our life, is it? Then, attuned to the plaintive babbling, attuned is nothing but adjust to the plaintive nothing but sounding sad, babbling of the river along the cool shade of its wooden banks. Wooden is nothing but forest. So there is both side, it is completely forest, completely full of trees. In between the river is going, so it looks very beautiful to see. Then the Bengal sky full of light, this south breeze, this flow of river, this right and royal laziness, this broad leisure stretching from horizon to horizon and from green earth to blue sky, all this that to me as food and drink to this to satisfy his hunger and his thirsty. So all this which went to that beautiful river, the sky, green trees, tree here and there, this water is moving, all this it was like a food and water to him. He himself, if you see all those things, he will not get hunger or thirsty because that himself fulfill his life, which the beautiful trees, there is then a blue sky, moving water, along with that, that is then beautiful nature. Okay, next. So not only it fulfills Tagore's hunger and thirsty, it is also like home to him. It is like a home to him, and in these I recognize the ministrations of the mother. Ministration is nothing but the act of helping, that is the act of caring. How the mother take care of the child. It is when the child is on the lap of the mother, he himself feel very warm in that. In such a way, Rabindranath Tagore feel himself very comfortable, and he himself feels that nature is taking care of him in a comfortable way, like how mother take care of his child. Okay, so this is what is given in the paragraph. Then, that was not so very long, and yet time was rough, many changes. Our little riverside nest clustering under the sounding greenery have been replaced by mills, which now dragon-like everywhere rear their hissing sound, belching forth black smoke. In the midday glare of modern life, even our hours of mental siesta has been narrowed down to the lowest limit. And hydra-headed unrest has invaded every department of life. Maybe this is for the better, but I for one cannot account it wholly to the good. Children, in this lesson we have lot of hard words, so make sure that you are reading this lesson again and again, so that it will be easy for you to read. It will increase your reading vocabulary also. Okay, let's see here. So that was not so very long. So actually that the way how he was impressed with the nature, that was not longing for him, because now that beautiful nature, that is wherever he see, he saw a beautiful nature, wherever he came, he used to see the beautiful nature, but now it has been replaced by the mills which has a very big towers, is it, from that the smokes come out. So here he compares the mills with the dragon. If you see dragon, by the which has overcome the nature. See here, a little riverside nest clustering under the surrounding greenery. That surrounding greenery, then riverside nest. Riverside nest means here nest means riverside houses. Then surrounding greenery has been replaced by mills, and that mills is compared with the dragon. Okay, so dragon, and then from that the smoke and noise comes out. Mama, how he is comparing the sound with the hissing head. You see, he said how the snake, snakes give the hissing sound. So he is comparing with that. Then blenching for black smoke. Yeah. Blenching in the sense, meaning of blenching is to let air come out. So it gives a black smoke. In the midday glare of modern life, even our hours of mental siesta has been narrowed down to the lowest limit. So during his during those days in the childhood, he used to take a mental siesta. Siesta in the sense, that is little rest. In the afternoon, they take rest. No, they have a short sleep. So that has got narrowed. That has got down. Now there is no one is taking rest in the morning because they are running out for their job and work. Is it? From they got up in the morning till night, they are running to earn money. So he is saying. So this has got narrowed. Who is saying? Rabindranath Tagore. Narrowed down to the lowest limit and hydra-headed. Hydra-headed in the sense with many problems. Okay, with many problems, unrest has invaded in every department of life. It is not, we cannot say it is only with one department they have. They are unrest in all, each and everywhere. Here and there, if you see, they are every, all, each and every life are filled with the problems now. So maybe this is for the better, but I for one cannot account it wholly to the good. So actually, it is a better thing because they are moving, our technology is getting improved. But he feels that this is not good. He says that I am not feeling this is good because he himself feels comfortable with the nature. When he sees the mills, people are working day and night for their improvement, it is good. But he feels that he is not satisfied with that life, with that modern life. Who? Rabindranath Tagore. Then, this lovely days of mine at the riverside passed by like so many dedicated lotus blossoms floating down the sacred stream. Okay, so actually those lovely days, when he sits near the riverside he has seen that many lotus blossoms and it floats on the sacred river. Some rainy afternoons I spent in the veritable, meaning of veritable is more exciting, veritable frenzy, singing away old Vaishnava songs to my own tunes, accompanying myself on the harmonium. So many rainy afternoon he has spent himself singing the old Vaishnava songs, giving his own tunes and playing harmonium. Okay. Then, on other afternoon, we would drift along with the boat, my brother Jyotindra accompanying my singing with his violin. So, he has spent many days by sitting near the riverside and feeling the beauty of lotus, how it blossoms on the sacred rivers. And then he has spent many afternoon, that is many rainy afternoon by singing all the Vaishnava songs in his own tone and playing harmonium. Not only that, he has sat on the boat along with his brother Jyotindra. He will sing the song and Jyotindra will play violin. So can you see in this picture, they have shown you. He has spent many days like that. Then, and as beginning with the Kuravi, we went on a varying the mode of our music with the declining day. We saw on reaching the Bahanga, the western sky closes the door of its factory of golden toys, and moon on the east rise over the fringe of trees. So here is saying that from the sunrise till it goes to the sunset, declining day, then the sunset, he used to sing songs, he used to enjoy the nature, and he will come to the, that is Bahanga in the sense, when they come even to the midnight, they will not stop, they will not come. There is here, what they, not present, the children, they are all busy with their night. He used to admire the nature. Okay? Yes. Now let us see page number 94. Then we will go back to the landing steps of the villa and seat ourselves on the quilt spread on the terrace facing the river. By then, a silvery peace rested on both land and water. Hardly any boats were about. The fringe of trees on the bank was reduced to deep shadow, and moonlight glimmered over the smooth flowing stream. So here, what they do? They sit near. That is, they sit in the landscape of villa. That is, they sit in the veranda. Then there is quilt spread, na soft bedspread. They will spread, and they by facing the side of the river. They will sit there and they will admire the nature, how that moon lights is focused on the land and the water. How there is, they see, they will admire themselves. There is, they enjoy how the moonlight is spread on the land and water. Okay, by sitting in the veranda, they will spread a soft cloth and they will sit over there and they will use to recognize the nature and they write poets. Okay, then. The villa we were living in was known as Moran's Garden. So the place where they were living, that villa, because this is the apartment, the place where they were living, it is called as the Moran's Garden. The flight of stone flagged steps led up from the water to a long broad veranda which formed part of the house. The rooms were not regularly arranged, nor all on the same level, and some had to be reached by short flight of stairs. The big sitting room overlooking the lamp steps had stained glass window with colored pictures. So the place where they lived is called as the Moran's Garden, and the flight of stone flag. Stone flag is nothing but square piece of the list that steps come on. One step is big, one step is small, so it is not arranged properly, which goes to the veranda. Then, which is formed a part of the house, and is also a part of the house. Then the rooms, actually the house, no, the each and every house will have different, we have a rooms, is it? So that rooms, it is not in the regular, they are not regularly arranged. One room is small, one room is big. So it is not regularly arranged, nor on the same level, and some had to be reached by short flight of stairs. The big, then they have the some room, they has to be reached with the short steps they have, and they are having a big hall. Actually, we have a hall, no? In such a way, they had a big sitting room, big hall, overlooking the landing steps, and then they had stained glass windows with colored pictures. So now we can see, there is they have a glass, and that they have pictures over there. They got pictures, otherwise the beautiful nature picture they have. So this is fitted in the hall. So I'll read the paragraph once again. See, the villa where living, it was known as the Moran's Garden. The flight of stone flagged steps led up from the water to a long broad veranda which formed a part of the house. So that steps which moved to the veranda, it is also a part of the house. The rooms are not regularly arranged, not in the same level, and some have to be reached by the short flight of stairs. There is a big sitting room overlooking the landing steps, has stained glass window with colored factuals. Some far away, long forgotten rivalry, meaning of rivalry, lively and noisy festivals, seem to be expressing itself in silent word of light. So some feels some fix it silently and watch what is there. They try to grab that completely. What is that in the picture? The love thrills of swinging couple making alive with eternal story the woodlands of river bank. So I told you, two couples are sitting in that swing. That lovely couples by seeing that lovely couples, he himself feels very enjoyable. Okay, then the topmost room of the house was in the round tower with windows opening to every side. This I used as my room for writing poetry. So in the topmost there is a room in which the windows are all open, and that room he used to sit and write the poetry. Okay, nothing could be seen from thence. Thence it is there, save the tops of surrounding trees and open sky. I was then busy with the evening songs of this room I wrote. So when he goes to the topmost room, nothing will be seen over there, only the sky and trees. And by sitting over there, he used to write songs and he himself read the songs and then he enjoys them. Okay, they were high in the breast of limitless space, clouds are left to sleep. I have built my house for the quiet sea. So he is saying that it is like a limitless space, clouds are left to sleep. So when he goes to his room, he feels himself like he has a limitless space. This which is he has a big space where he can sleep and he can dedicate this. I have built my house, and he has dedicated this house to the poetry. That is the poetry. That big place he has dedicated. That is poetry. All his house is dedicated to the poetry. So this is what is given in the My Reminiscences. Actually, children, here reminiscences is this lesson tells the practice of thinking or telling about the Rabindranath's past experience. So when you read this lesson, you will get many hard words. So make sure that you are writing these hard words in the classwork and finding meanings for those hard words. Okay, children. Now let us discuss the filling the blanks, which is there in the page number 95. The author speaks about the river Ganges. The author's brother's name is Jyotindra. The dash glimmered over the smooth flowing stream. The moonlight glimmered over the smooth flowing stream. The beauty of Bengal and Ganges served as food